Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this professional cover page in Word. So the first thing we're going to do is just pop in the graphics. So we're going to go to Insert, Picture, click on the drop down, and we're going to choose from stock images, but you can obviously choose a picture of your choosing. You can choose from your files. I'm just going to go to stock images. And because of my color palette, I'm going to just simply put in orange and teal in the search bar at the top, and then select this image here and then click insert. When you insert an image into Word, you can't move it. So right click on it, go down to wrap text and select in front of text. And we want to crop this to a triangle. So select it, go to picture format, go to crop, click on the drop down and select crop to shape. And select this triangle, and then we're going to rotate this triangle and move it to the bottom, and then we're just going to make this a little bit bigger. Now, as you can see, when I put my triangle in the shape, I had to turn it round. Obviously that's not going to suit you if you choose something that isn't a little bit more abstract like this. So you can just rotate your picture, then crop it to whichever shape you want. Okay, now we're going to insert a shape. So go to insert, shapes, click on the drop down, and then we're going to move down to this shape here and just click, and then just click and drag out the shape we want. Now these shapes are great because they've got this yellow box here. And if you click and drag, you can change the shape and angles of this particular shape. It doesn't happen with all shapes, but on some of them it does. Just gives you that extra flexibility. Now I'm going to change the color of this shape. So select it, go to shape format. Over here, it has actually got a borderline. Just click on this drop down and select no outline. And then I'm going to go to shape fill and I'm going to select this color here. If you can't see the color you want here, go to more fill colors. You've got your color wheel here. Move this little cursor around the color wheel to choose the color of your choice. You've got a brightness slider here, so you can change the brightness of that color. And then you've also got other options across the top here that you can also select from. And then just click OK. So now I'm just going to move this down. So the first thing I'm going to do is ensure that the bottom piece here is actually perfectly straight. You can see it lines up with the bottom of the page. So this section at the bottom here is perfectly horizontal. And then all I'm going to do, I'm going to move this up, just make sure that comes down a little bit. And then I'm actually going to move this yellow marker so that the actual angle lines up with the angle of this triangle. So all the lines are parallel. Otherwise it's going to look a little bit odd. And then I'm just going to use my arrow key just to move that shape out a little bit. And now I'm going to copy and paste this shape twice. So you can either use the normal, go to home, copy, deselect, paste. That's one way to do it. The other way is Command or Control C, deselect Command or Control V. Or you can select the shape, hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag. And that's obviously the easiest way to do it. Now we're going to create a graphic here, and it's really easy to do, but it's also very effective. So I'm going to change this shape to white, go to shape format, shape fill, white. Now you can't see it, but I'm going to move it down here. You can just see it moving there. And I'm going to move it to the back. You can see it's at the front at the moment, and it's in front of all of the shapes. So I'm going to move it to the back. So go to shape format, go to send backwards, click on the drop down and click center back. And then I'm going to move this shape down. I'm going to also move this to the back. And now you can see what we're trying to create. So I'm going to move this shape so that it creates a little border line round about there. And then I'm going to line this one up as well. Now again, this is personal taste. You can make this line as thick or as thin as you want. Perfect. And then we're going to do exactly the same at the top. Again, I'm going to hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag this one up here. And then I'm just going to make this one a little bit wider. Move that over. Then again, I'm going to copy this twice. using my Alt or Option key. I'm also going to change the color. So I'm going to select this one here, go to Shape Fill, and I'm going to use my recent colors, change this one to orange, and then this one's going to be white. And we're going to do exactly the same. I'm going to send that one backwards, click on this one, and then center back as well. So once again, we're going to create a similar kind of shape or pattern at the bottom here. We're just going to insert the final shape. So go to Shapes, click on the drop down and select the square. Click and drag out a long rectangle. Now for this shape, we're going to use a gradient. So in order to access the gradients, click on the shape, go to Shape Format, and go over to Format Pane. Now this may already have appeared. If not, you can either go to Format Pane or you can double click on your shape and the same menu will appear. So we're going to go to the bucket icon. This refers to all of the colors and the fills and the border lines. So once again, we're going to go to line and select no line. And that's the border line we've just got rid of. Go to fill and go down to gradient fill. Now by default, this is the gradient I've got. And you can see that with this gradient slider here. And I've got four markers on this gradient, but I don't want four markers. I only want two. So you can see this marker you've selected because it's got an orange outline. I'm just going to go on to this remove gradient stop. And once again, I'm going to click on it again and it will get rid of another one. I'm just going to move this slider to the end. And then you can choose your gradients by the colors. So select the marker, go to color, and then you can choose once again from all of your colors, and you can choose more colors at the bottom as well. And I'm going to select this gray here. And then for this color here, I'm simply going to click white. And then all I'm going to do with this shape is rotate it using this icon at the top here, this rotation icon. I'm going to rotate it again so that it lines up with the lines of the graphics we've already put in. And then I'm going to put it wherever I like on my design. Again, I'm going to copy and paste quite a few of these. I'm going to have a couple there, and then I'm going to have a couple at the bottom as well, and I'm going to rotate those. So just to customize these, I'm going to move this one over and move this one over. I'm going to move all of these to the back. So center back, click on it, center back, click on it, and do the same, center back. I'm also going to change the color of this particular gradient. So this box here I've selected the gray, and I'm going to select a lighter gray. And I'm going to do the same with this one, select a lighter gray. Then for this one, I'm going to rotate it. Again, lining up those angles so we're all completely parallel. I'm going to put this one down the bottom here, and this one round about here. In fact, I'm going to rotate that one as well. And you can also make these thicker or thinner, depending on the look you're going for. Again, center back, and this one center back. Perfect, so once you're happy with all your graphics, we're going to put the text in. And to do that, I'm going to use text boxes. I'm just going to move this graphic over a bit because I can see it's just come over the line. There we go. Go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. Click and drag out a text box. And you can see if I deselect my text box, I've got a black border and a white background. So I'm going to type and then get rid of both of those. So let's just type out, and then I'm going to select my text by clicking and dragging, go to the Home tab. I'm going to change the font to HeliVector. And I'm going to change it to light, but I'm also going to change it to bold. And I'm going to change the color to the orange. And I'm going to change the font size to 72 and press enter. I'm going to then go to shape format. I'm going to take out the outline and take out the fill, the white background, and just select no fill. And then we can move this anywhere we like in our design. I'm just going to pop it here for a second. Now, because we've customized this text box, we can use it over and over again. So I can then just hold down my Alt or Option key and click out another one. And for this one, I'm going to type in corporate. I'm going to select all of this text. Just press Command or Control A if you can't click and drag. Go to the Home tab. This time I'm going to choose the normal helivector. And I'm going to choose bold for that as well. And this text is going to be 60. Press Enter. Just extend the box out so you can fit all the words in. There we go. I'm going to copy and paste this box again because I'm going to use the same font. I'm just going to take the bold off. So I'm just going to type design, take the bold off. In fact, it's not selected. Take the bold off. And then I'm going to change this to 60 again. Press Enter. Just adjust the size of that box. And then I'm going to line all of these up. Just select one of the boxes, hold down the Command or Control key, select them all. Go to Shape Format, go to Align, click on the drop down. And the first thing we're going to do is distribute them vertically. And that means there's going to be an equal distance between all of those lines of text. And then align to left. Make sure they're all lined up along that left border. And then go to Group and select Group. Now you can move this around any way you like and it will move as one element. So I'm just going to go back and ungroup them because I need to borrow one of these boxes again. So select it, hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag. Then I'm going to go along, put some more text in, go to Home, and then I'm going to reduce the size of this to 22. Press Enter. I'm going to align it over to the right by clicking on this icon here. I'm going to use bold. In fact, I'm going to use the normal helivector. Use bold. And one of the tricks you can do with the fonts is you can just space out the characters a little bit more just to give that added contemporary look to it. So if you select your font or your text, right click, go down to font, go to advanced, and then in this spacing here, you can either use the arrow keys or you can just put in a figure here. I'm going to put in 5 and then press enter. And as you can see, I've spaced out my characters just a little bit more. Now I'm going to change the color. Choose this dark color here. Perfect. And then I'm going to borrow this text box again. Hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag, and then click the cursor inside. And I'm going to just change this to, you can put whatever you want here. I'm just showing you how the design can work. I'm going to choose a font size of 14, and I'm just going to change the color to this lighter teal color. Just reduce the size of the box. Move that up. I'm going to just try and line up that E with the other one there. And then finally, let's just grab this box here. Hold down my Alt or Option key, click and drag. And then again, I'm just going to put some text in here. So I'm going to delete that text and just paste in this text here. And this text is 11. And also the font color is this darker teal here. Great thing about text boxes is you can move them and shape them so you can move the text so the paragraph will fit and look exactly how you want it to. That's great, and I'm just lining up that text with the edge of this text as well. And then the final flurry is just to put some lines in. Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and select a line. So click, hold down your Shift key and drag, and it will drag out a perfectly horizontal line, which will mean that you don't have to worry about the angle of that line. And then I'm going to go over to the menu here. I'm going to go to Line, and I'm going to change the color to the dark teal. And then the width I'm going to put to 3 and press Enter. Then without deselecting that line, I'm going to go to Home, Copy, deselect it, paste. I'm going to grab that line and bring it down here. Once again, try and line it up the side of the text. Then back over here, I'm going to choose the orange color, and then I'm going to click on the green ball and just hold down my Shift key and drag that line out a little bit more. Again, this is all personal preference, so you can have a shorter line or a longer line, it's completely up to you. Now you can group everything together. Again, select it, hold down the Command or Control key, select everything. Now I'm not going to align it to the left because it will move this line all the way out to the edge of these text boxes, and that's not what I want. Then go to Group and select Group, and now you can move all of this round as one element so that you can really start to manipulate it to suit your design. Again, you can do the same up here. Hold down that Command or Control key to select everything, select Group, group again, and again, you can move this wherever you want. So once you've finished your design, you can just simply print it out, or you can save it as a PDF, or you can even save it as a template. So to save it as a PDF, go to File, Save As, rename it, go down to the bottom here and select PDF, and then click Save, or go to File, Save as Template. This will mean you can use this template over and over again, just make small adjustments to it. And then make sure it's saved under Templates and File Format, ensure it's under Microsoft Word Template, and then just click Save. Perfect. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.